Carlo Taticchi from Italy, from Gran Sasso Science Institute. My supervisor is Professor Sasso Mistarelli, and this is a proposal for the work for my PhD thesis. That we intend to develop a concurrent language based on argumentation, capable of handling processes like negotiation and debating. So I want to convince you about the capabilities of argumentation. Rather, I want to talk a bit about the issues on representing, on formally representing argumentation processes from a computational point of view. First of all, I will give you a brief background on the tools that we use working on these topics, and I'll spend a few words on the state of the art on languages for expressing argumentation processes, and then I'll talk about my proposal. So, one of the building blocks of argumentation in computer science are argumentation frameworks by Gran. You can represent it as a directed graph in which we have arguments, A, B, C, that, as you can see, are abstract. That is, you have no epistemic meaning on the nodes, but you just care about the relation among them. You just care that A is attacking C, no matter what A or C means. And what we're interested in argumentation frameworks is how they evolve. That is, you can modify them, you can acquire the information. For example, with all the nice techniques in argument mining and so on. And you can end up in obtaining a new argumentation framework that represents possibly a completely different situation with a different meaning, or how we call it, different semantics. That is a criteria under which we evaluate the acceptability of the argument. For instance, here the argument E, before the modification, was not acceptable under what we call admissible semantics, that require for definition that if E is attacked by some other argument, then a friend of E has to defend him. As we can see here, after the modification, F is attacking D, that is attacking E, and since the enemy of my enemy is my friend, then E and F together are acceptable under the admissible semantics. So, we can actually build argumentation frameworks starting from a debate among two people, for example, politicians. We can do also some things slightly different, like negotiate on an outcome. We don't need to win an argument, but in some times, all we need is to get an arrangement between counterparts. You can negotiate everything, content from our service. Google negotiate pricing on the ads he puts on the web searches. The load balancer negotiates the workload with the server in the system. And the problem is here how I can model this kind of situation. How can I express in a way that is approachable under computational aspects? Some work related to this topic, for instance, allow to build argumentation frameworks starting from a so-called universe in which have pieces, for example, argument and every possible attack or relation I can have between arguments. And starting from this universe, I can build local view of framework, and I can have different one for each agent that is in my system. These kind of languages are typically logic language. That is, I can actually use techniques as revision or update following the AGM or KM postulates, many of you may know it. What we totally miss here is the concurrency, or how the agents interact between each other. This is something that other authors in other words approach, like in this one, some authors use the dynamic logic of propositional assignment to obtain a language capable of model the interaction between between agents in that are able to modify argumentation frameworks providing arguments. They also provide some kind of operational semantics in order to enforce subset of arguments. For instance, here I want to make A admissible under a semantic sigma, and I have this operation that provide me the like a tool for building arguments that will defend what I'm asserting. Okay, so to enforce a particular party, for instance, in a diagram. Okay, what we want to do is to merge these different techniques and approaches into a language that is both capable of modeling agents while preserving the concurrency of what you are asserting on the system. Because you have to take into account the interaction between the agents and when does this interaction happen. So we want to first of all use the ascended paradigm by Sasso that consists in two operations. You can ask in a framework if a certain subset of argument is acceptable with respect to a certain semantics. Here, for instance, A and C are admissible semantics because C is defended by A from the type of B. So the answer is yes. Then you can tell, you can say, okay, now consider an argument D, and this argument is attacking C in my framework. But now, if I ask the same question as before, that is A and C are admissible, the answer is no. Because you don't have stability in this kind of process, because we are dealing with no monotonic reading. And so we want to introduce a set of operators, of rules, that we defined in a previous work, we called it invariant operator, that allow you to introduce modification of this kind of frameworks without changing the semantics. So this will act as a filter for the operations that are allowed on framework. And in this case, an invariant tell wouldn't allow me to assert D, for instance. And of course, we want to consider and implement the operation of parallel composition of assertion and the non-deterministic choice, because you don't ever know which agents which is the actions that an agent would perform. An agent would do A or C, but in certain cases you may not know, and so you need non-determinants to model this kind of situation. A very trivial example with a load balancer in a high-performance system. You have a worker, a server, let's say, that can be either free and busy. And so the load balancer can assign a job to the worker, but then the worker will not be free anymore. Or the worker could finish his job so that he wouldn't be busy anymore. And this is a really trivial example, really trivial interaction. But here you do need the notion of agent system and concurrency for modeling this kind of process, in which you have to know in which of the two states you are, which come first and second, and which are the operations that are actually performed by the system. Of course, you're in a multi-agent environment, so various workers can interact together, and here you can put some constraints, for example, due to security policies, so that may allow or not allow particular acts between arguments or particular arguments itself. And also for the case of modeling a debate in which you want to win the argument, so you want that your argument is the acceptable one and you want to defeat argument, counter-attacking argument, with the language we are proposing, you are able to pick part of information from your knowledge base and use it to counter-attack the attack of other agents. You can do more. You can also set up a strategy for countering the possible further moves of an agent. For example, B, the agent, the red agent that assert B, know that the green agent could assert C. So he would say D before. So I've countered the attack of the green agents towards my agent. Okay, this was just a gather of ideas that I want